Hi friends, today we are going to see what are the analysis of arithmetic round off in a fixed point number. So why this analysis is so important? In fixed point number, as we know that we are denoting only fractionals, okay, round off can produce a huge amount of problem. Why we are considering round off? If we consider a direct form 2, let's draw a direct form 2 structure. So I have designed a filter, and that filter is been implemented using a direct form 2 structure. Let's say that the order of the filter is 2. So I have 2 in Z inverses, and then I have 2 multipliers. Isn't it? So we have a multiplier, let's say alpha 1, alpha 2, which is minus. Okay, this is one node, this is second node, and this goes as an input to this node. Correct? Now, after I am getting a number over here, if I multiply it with alpha 1, if alpha 1 and the number that I get, let's say I am getting this as wn, this is wn minus 1, this is wn minus 2. Correct? So if I am getting wn minus 1 as some b bit number, and my alpha 1 is also a b bit number, then the product might be a 2b bit number. Correct? This 2b bit number will go up, will come back, isn't it? By multiplying, getting added with the input. So how can I store or process a 2b bit number? So whenever I'm producing, I'm having a multiplication in a DSP system or in the filter, then I have to do some type of round off. And this round off can produce a very dangerous scenario on the performance of the digital circuit. So how and what type of error occurs if I do the rounding in the digital filter? That analysis we'll be doing in this section. So let us consider a very general case, not to be very specific, second order, direct form 2, not like that. Just a generic case. You know that now, as far as that circuit is concerned, that there is multiplication. Okay, so let us assume that I have a practical multiplier with quantizer into it. So I have a multiplier to which I'm getting the input as u of n, and its value is alpha. And after multiplication, I'm going to produce an output called v of n. And then I'll be performing a rounding. So the function that I'm using, I'm writing here as q. Okay, but that q stands for rounding. I'm rounding it, and I'm going to get a new factor or a new value, that which we call as v cap of n, which will not be same as that of v of n, of course. If I use the statistical model of this q, then it will look like I have this idealized multiplier whose output is V of n with infinite precision, and I'm giving the now I'll consider this to be an adder to which input is E of n, and the output produced is V cap of n. Let us denote this as E alpha of n, and the output produces V cap of n. Then from the equation, I can easily write as V cap of n equals to V of n, which is the idealized output plus the error that has occurred due to the finite precision. Okay. Now we will assume that E of n is statistically uncorrelated, okay, or we can assume that E of n is a WSS, okay, white noise process, Okay. Second, okay, the E of n is uncorrelated with each other, because there would be n number of such multipliers in the system. Therefore, I'm assuming that every multiplier will have its own error, and that all errors are uncorrelated with each other, and it is also uncorrelated to input and output. So there is no relation between input and output and E of n. Okay. And third, I will also assume that E of n is uniformly distributed. Okay, so these are my assumption. First assumption, it's a wide sense stationary white noise process. Then the all the errors, whichever error occurs, they are all uncorrelated. They are independent. They are not dependent on each other. They are also independent of the input and the output. Okay, and it is uniformly distributed. Okay, with this assumption, the probability density function that I will get for the error is minus delta by 2 to delta by 2 up to delta. This is my probability density function for the error, which states that the mean of the error is 0 and sigma e square is delta square by 12. Okay, so that is the variance or the power of the noise, which is delta square by 12. Now let us go ahead and see that what effect does it put if I consider a total digital circuit. So suppose if I have a digital filter which I make with just a black box. I don't know which type of form we are using, either cascade or parallel or direct form 1 or direct form 2 or whatsoever. And the input coming to this is x of n, and the output given is y cap of n. Okay, and let's say there are certain inputs which I have just shown you. There are certain nodes which goes inside of the filter like this. Okay, and this node I called as an rth node, which is ur of n, and there are some multipliers which we show like this. A multiplier at m1 is the multiplier number 1, which has a quantizer at its output, which is q, okay, and which is going to an adder. Fine. And there are other such inputs that are also coming to this adder, which are also quantized q and have some multiplier, let's say m, k, l. And the output of this multipliers is going to the filter back. Okay. And the output of this lth branch is VL of n. Understood? So if you are finding it really difficult to visualize this, let me go back and show you the direct two form. Now in this direct two form, you see that to this adder, there are two inputs. Okay, and they got multipliers. So what I'm considering that after alpha 1, I will have one more quantizer. After alpha 2, I will have another quantizer. And then and they both, now I should not have any adder over here because it is figure 2. So it will go directly, isn't it? So here at this let's say is the second summator. Likewise, if suppose there is an lth summator. So to that L summator, there might be many other such inputs coming to it. Okay. So that I am considering that here it is alpha 1 and alpha 2. So MKL value is alpha 2. M1 value is alpha 1. Okay. So likewise, there are L such components at the Lth branch I am considering. This is the first branch I am considering. Isn't it? So likewise, I am considering the Lth branch. And at Lth branch, there are so many number of multipliers coming, which are all quantized and they are added together, and the output of which goes back to some other adder, okay, which I represent to be V, L, N. So we can consider here that there are L, the Lth input that I'm getting. Now, because of quantization, the output is not Y of N, but it is Y cap of N, and it is changed its mode now. So now what I'll do is, let us pull out this much part and analyze that what will be the error that occurred over, can occur over here. As we know that there are L total quantizers, so we will have L total noise sources. So I can represent this with the model like this. Let us model it. So I will show that let's say this is my digital filter. This is the input that I'm giving, which is X of N. This is the output I'm achieving, which is Y cap of N. And I'm not showing what is happening down. Let us go up. So now I'm having a Lth branch. I have the first branch, which have a multiplier. And that multiplier, I am modeling it with one more adder, to which I have an input of E1 of N. Okay, and that goes output to the adder. Okay, this is the final adder where I'm going to get the output as VL of N. Correct. Now, this is my M1. Agreed. Now, if I go Lth steps like this, there are many inputs. So there will be E1 of N, there will be E2 of N, there will be ELK of N. So I have another adder over here, to which the input is EMK, or let's say EM or EKL of N. Okay, and here the input is coming with MKL as a multiplier. Okay, so now we know that there are independent sources. So I can write independent sources, total error at Lth branch will be E of N, which is nothing but E1 of N into E2 of N, and so on and so forth to EKL of N, because they are statistically independent. Because they are statistically independent, that's why I will have this property. Now, the final output that goes in, which is VL of N. Now, let us analyze that what will be the total process because of this noise. If suppose I consider that sigma naught square is the variance of each noise. Is the variance of individual noise sources. Okay. At the output of each multiplier. So they are all individual noise sources. Then EL of N, that is total at the Lth branch, the total error is nothing but K times of sigma naught square, because how many error sources are there? There are total k error sources at the Lth branch. Okay, so I'll have k ln k times of n sigma naught sources, and I'm saying that each one of them have the same sigma naught square variance. Then the output due to this will be, okay, the output will be nothing but transfer function, okay, some transfer function into the input. Okay, so we will write in terms of Z transform. So the output, okay, caused by EL of N will be what? So if suppose to get the output due to the noise, we should know what transfer function does the system provides to this noise. So if suppose I consider GL of Z to be my noise transfer function of the system, this is noise transfer function, okay, and this is due to the rounding effect, then okay, my output will be nothing but, what will be output? Output will be nothing but transfer function, which is GL of Z into the input, which is EL of N. This is the only output at the Lth branch due to the rounding. So there will be k such more, there will be other branches error also, and together when they summed up, we are going to get the final error in the output. Okay, so this will be given as sigma naught square, okay, summation goes from L equals to 1 to, let's say, capital K into small k L, okay, into 1 upon 2 pi, integral goes from minus pi to pi, okay, modulus of G L of e raised to j omega mod square d omega. Okay, so this is what the total output due to the error E of N. Okay, so this is what the output due to the arithmetic rounding at the multipliers in the digital filter. So this transfer function, this is, I have taken the Fourier transform and I have considered the Fourier transform domain. Okay, so we can write that the error, the output due at the Lth branch, or let's say the output, or we can also write this output because we are considered from L is equal to 1 to some capital K, I can write this output as y cap instead of just writing it as output. If I write it only output, then I have to consider that at what branch output I am considering. Okay, because at every branch the transfer function will be different. Okay, so if I consider the total branches, the total sum up, then the total sum will go from L is equal to 1 to capital K. So let's say there are k total branches, and KL is the total number of branches that are inputting at the Lth branch. Okay, and that's why this will be the total amount of the output error. I hope you have understood that what happens if I actually have a rounding at the multiplier section in a digital filter. Thank you.